Hi, my name is Robin Wong. In my recent review video of the Olympus MZUIKO 12-45 f4 Pro lens, I've asked if you want to see a comparison between that lens and the older 12-40 f2.8 Pro lens. Looking at the comment section, the response was a general resounding yes. Hence, I'm making this comparison video. Let's do this. In that previous video, I've also mentioned that the Olympus 12-40 f2.8 Pro was an excellent lens. If you've already owned that lens, there is no reason for you to get the new 12-45 f4 Pro. However, in that previous video, I also made a bold claim that the new 12-45 f4 Pro lens is slightly sharper than the 12-40 f2.8 Pro lens. That claim was unverified. I didn't do any side-by-side comparison between the two lenses. I made that claim based on my experience using both lenses separately, so I'm making this video to verify if that claim was true or not. Before we get into the image quality differences between the two lenses, let's look at the differences and similarities between the 12-45 f4 Pro and the 12-40 f2.8 Pro. Both lenses belong to the Pro Grade MZUIKO Olympus lens category. They're both weather sealed, having dust, splash, and freeze proof down to minus 10 degrees. Both lenses are made of metal construction. They are very well constructed. Both lenses also do not have internal zoom, meaning that when you zoom the lens from the wide to the telephoto end, the lens does stand out. The lenses, however, do have internal focusing mechanism, meaning that the front element does not rotate. Also, being Pro Grade lenses, both these lenses have superb optical design. Moving on to the differences between the two lenses, the 12-45 f4 Pro is a newer lens and it has a fixed aperture opening of f4 versus f2.8 on the older 12-40 f2.8 Pro lens. The 12-45 f4 Pro is also designed to be smaller and lighter, matching smaller Olympus camera bodies such as the Pan and the OMD 10 series. The Olympus 12-45 f4 Pro lens doesn't have the manual focusing clutch mechanism and also is missing a lens function customizable button. On the other hand, the older 12-40 f2.8 Pro has both these features. My testing methodology is very simplistic. I'm testing the 12-45 f4 Pro versus the 12-40 f2.8 Pro on my own Olympus EM5 Mark III. I'm not using a tripod, everything was done handheld. This was because it was almost impossible even to match the frame in composition using the tripod. I acknowledge that there'll be some differences when it comes to framing. It is impossible to match everything 100% unless I'm doing it in a studio environment, but we all know that when we use the Olympus cameras, not all of us actually shoot in studio, and having the camera out there in real life situation is more representative of the kind of results that we get from the camera and lenses. I'll do my best to make sure that all the settings are consistent, including the focusing point. Also, bear in mind that there will be some cases of sample variation. My Olympus 12-45 f4 Pro is a sample review unit from Olympus. There is a possibility that it varies in terms of final optical performance that is found in the mass production units. Even within the mass production units themselves, one lens may be slightly different from another. Sample variation is a real thing. So there is a possibility that your 12-45 may be slightly better or slightly worse than my 12-45 f4 Pro lens. With that out of the way, let's start with the wide angle 12mm comparison. For consistency, the images displayed on the screen, the left image will be the one taken from the 12-45 f4 Pro lens, and the image on the right will be from the 12-40 f2.8 Pro. The image quality between two lenses are very, very close. Looking at the sharpness, the contrast, and the amount of details that is captured, it is not that easy to tell apart which lens takes which photograph. For the 12mm wide angle comparison, looking at the center crop of the image, zooming into 100%, it is actually noticeable that there is slight advantage to the 12-45 f4 Pro. This does not mean that the 12-40 Afterweight Pro is a poor performer. The results are so close that the slight difference is almost negligible. However, if you really scrutinize and pixel peep at areas in the photograph that has lines and texture, you can see that the 12-45 F4 Pro has a slight edge in rendering slightly more detail in comparison to the 12-40 F2.8 Pro. It is not just the sharpness that I'm impressed with, but I'm also very amazed by the contrast that's captured by the 12-45 F4 Pro. The contrast that's captured by this lens is very similar to what is seen in the older brother 12-100 F4 Pro. Now, we do get a slightly different story when we move to the corners. I think the 12-40 F2.8 Pro, the older lens, performs slightly better in the corner sharpness in comparison to the newer 12-45 F4 Pro. Again, the differences is not that big. You can actually see it is slightly softer in the 12-45 F4 Pro, but this is not a big issue. Moving on to the telephoto end for both lenses. When comparing both lenses at the longest end, the 45mm for the 12-45mm lens, and at 40mm for the 12-40mm lens, it is quite noticeable that the Olympus 12-40 has a minor advantage. The images look slightly crispier, it is slightly sharper, and you can see slightly more details in the 12-40 F2.8 Pro. I have tested these lenses for a few occasions. Out of the many sample photographs that I have taken, I'm only showing you a few. The results have been consistent. It is the same for all my comparisons. The 12-40 F2.8 Pro is slightly sharper than the 12-45 Pro. I think I forgot to mention that for all the tests I'm performing up to this point, I'm sticking at f4 aperture for both lenses for consistency. Nevertheless, as I've mentioned earlier, the differences are so minute that I believe the 12-45 F4 Pro is very, very close to the sharpness of the 12-40 F2.8 Pro. And at a glance, you can't really see a big difference. You can only really notice the difference if you scrutinize at both images at pixel level. In real-life practical shooting, this doesn't translate to any difference at all. I'll be glad to use the 12-45 F4 Pro and be happy with the results I'm getting from that lens. Next, let's look at the image quality taken by both lenses at close-up macro shooting. At really close-up shot, going really close to the subject, both lenses are very capable at rendering fantastic results. Looking at them side by side, it is almost impossible to tell a difference. I would say the close-up capability between the two lenses are very, very similar. If I have to pick a winner between these two lenses, I will have to lean toward the 12-45 F4 Pro. I will skip the chromatic aberration, vignetting, and distortion comparison between the two lenses because these technical lens controls are very well corrected by software in the camera. Looking at both lenses, I don't see any noticeable distortion, I don't see any chromatic aberration, and surely I don't see any cases of vignetting. In modern Olympus OMD and pan cameras, Olympus has effectively mitigated any of these technical lens flaws, and I don't see any point discussing them in this video review. Moving on to the starburst effect, when you point the 12-45 F4 Pro lens on a strong source of light, such as the sun, stopping down the aperture to f16 or f22, you do get a beautiful sunburst or the sun star effect. Of course, this effect is not the best I've seen of any lenses out there. Olympus do have other lenses that render better starburst effect, such as the 12mm f2 lens, as well as the 7-14 f2.8 Pro lens. For a 12-45 F4 Pro, for a standard zoom lens, I think the starburst effect is one of the better ones that I've seen out there. Comparing to what the 12-40 F2.8 Pro can do, I think the starburst effect looks exactly the same. Shooting against a strong source of light at wide open aperture at F4, the Olympus 12-45 F4 Pro lens exhibits lesser flare and ghosting in comparison to the 12-40 f2.8 Pro. Now we have come to the last item of our comparison test, which is the bokeh quality. Some people actually complain about the onion ring shaped bokeh found in some sample photographs available online. I don't know, seriously, I've been trying to replicate the onion ring effect in my photographs. It is not easy to do. I do get solid bokeh balls again and again in different scenarios, and the bokeh again looks pleasing, creamy, and beautiful. In fact, the onion ring bokeh was more prominent in the Olympus 12-40 f2.8 Pro. In comparison to the newer Olympus 12-45 F4 Pro, I think Olympus did something to the out of focus rendering. The bokeh on the Olympus 12-45 F4 Pro looks slightly smoother, and the bokeh ball is more solid and has less onion shape in it. That's all the comparison tests that I have in this video. I think that it is an incredible fact Olympus made a 12-45 f4 Pro lens, making it smaller and lighter, yet maintaining an optimum image quality, very close to the 12-40 f2.8 Pro. In fact, in some circumstances, it can surpass what the 12-40 f2.8 Pro can do. Again, may I remind you where I stand. If you already have the 12-40 f2.8 Pro and the 12-100 f4 Pro, there is absolutely no reason for you to get the 12-45 f4 Pro unless you want to match the lens to a smaller Olympus camera body. I do think that the Olympus 12-45 f4 Pro is a huge step up from the available kit lenses such as the 14-42 Pancake or the 12-50 older kit lens. If you have found this video helpful to you, please give me a thumbs up, please consider subscribing to this channel, and I will definitely see you again in the next one. Until then, please remember to go out and take more photographs. Bye-bye.